a friend of mine gave me Scotty Bowers's full service, My Adventures in Hollywood and the Secret Sex Lives of the Stars. And I watched a short CBS interview of Scotty, concluding that he's an honest, trustworthy, kind, and courageous person. When his interviewer on CBS asked what made people trust you, Scotty answered something to the effect, because they knew they could trust me. The interviewer may have pressed the issue and asked, but what made them think they could trust you? To which Scotty probably would have replied, because I was trustworthy. Maybe Scotty Bowers was the Billy Budd of Hollywood pimps. Although he might take umbrage at the term, because he never took money except when he himself was the trick. In fact, in the CBS interview, he excepted himself from the category pimp for this reason. At least he was no ordinary pimp. And I think, you know, how could he have been trustworthy if he finally spilled the beans? I'd say that as best I can tell, all the beans are now dead. But what about the good reputations of the dead? Are these not to be protected? Personally, I'm glad Scotty Bowers published his autobiography, despite the fact that I believe that a person's sex life is their own business. When I read the first couple of chapters a year ago, I was bored with the repetition. I mean, I put the book down until now, anyway. How many cocksuckings does one need to hear about? I didn't enjoy some ghostwriter putting the story to pen and ink, which I would have preferred to have been rendered by Scotty's own hand in his own sentence structure, revealing his own struggle to get it down right. But did Lionel Friedberg get Scotty down righter than perhaps Scotty was himself capable? I mean, was Scotty Bowers totally carefree? Did the unnecessary death of his approximately 22-year-old daughter occupy but a sentence, so to speak, in his life story? Was that it? Was it just a minor interruption suggested? As was suggested? To me, his autobiography is about himself only to the extent that he was present during all those potential sex scandals. It's only about himself to the extent we infer Scotty's without a care trustingness and trustworthiness. We infer that he really liked people, with the exception of the occasional James Dean, whom nobody liked. Scotty appears to have never struggled with who he was. Was his great personality and athletic body and his without a care in the world temperament the luck of the draw? Or was his lacking inner conflict the luck of the draw? All the conflict in his story is outside of himself, and the conflict so simple that the sexual service he provided seemed to be all that was necessary, all that was needed for conflict resolution. It was a Hollywood fairy tale.